Hey everyone, welcome to my channel Lenovit. Today we will going to discuss the normal structure of a neuron. A neuron is a specialized cell of the nervous system and it relies mostly in the central nervous system. Also, the cell bodies of the neuron in the peripheral nervous system make the ganglia. So the first feature of this neuron is it is different in structure from the normal somatic cells of the body. Number two, it is an excitable cell, which means that it can carry the electrical impulses. That's why it is given a specialized property of carrying the electrical impulse. This neuron is very much a specialized structure in the central nervous system or the brain of a human body. There are about 100 trillion of the neurons. And many of the neurons are present in the CNS and the PNS, and they are working for the integration and the stimulation of the central nervous system for the responses, for the synapses, for the afferent and the efferent information to be transmitted. And they are very important. So we have to discuss the structure of a simple neuron in this video. That is, you can see the structure. This structure, that is the upper expanded part, is called as the body of a neuron. The cell body or the soma of the neuron is star-like somewhat, and it have a central circular nucleus with a dark staining purplish nucleolus. This nucleolus is dark stained or stained basophilic because of the presence of large number of euchromatin. Also, you can see here, I can zoom this. In the nucleus of the neuron, there are presence of small dot-like structures of the purple color. These are the basophilic staining nasal substances. These nasal substances or the nasal granules in the nucleus of a neuron are responsible for the protein synthesis. That is a function of the neuronal cell to synthesize different proteins which are important for the integration of the nerve impulse. Then what are attached to the cell body? This cell body have many extensions. These extensions from the cell body are called as the neurites. And these neurites are extending from the cell body with the surrounding cytoplasm. The cytoplasm or the neuroplasm of the cell body of neuron is expanding into these neurites. So the small neurites that are extend from the cell body or the cell processes are called as the dendrites. These dendrites again branch and branch, and they taper off in their diameter and they form somewhat star-like structure. So these are the dendrites. And one large process that is going down from the cell body of the neuron is the axon. This axon is the main efferent pathway carrying the impulse from the cell body. Then this axon is terminated into several other branches that are called as the axonal terminals. So from the point where the axon start from the cell body is called as the axonal holic or the axon holic. From where the axon initiate and axon terminate at the axonal terminal, this part is called as the axonal terminal, which is expanded into a dendrite. And these dendrites have the neuronal bottoms or the nerve terminals. Now come to the functions of these neuronal structures that are present in a single neuron. So here we have discussed the nucleus, the main part that is integrating and the main important organ of the neuron to carry out all the activities is the nucleus. As we know, nucleus is very important in every cell, for the DNA, for the RNA replication, for the growth, for the maturation of the cell. Also, one more thing, that the neuronal cell does not grow throughout the life. It does not grow through the mitotic division. Once it has grown, it does not divide. Only the neuroblast cells that we will discuss later, that is the neuroglial cells that are different from the neurons, they grow and they increase in the quantity to increase the diameter of a brain. So the function of nucleus we have discussed. Then this is a cell body which has the cytoplasm and the cell membrane. That is, that this cell membrane is continuous with the dendrites. The function of dendrites is they carry the impulses from the central nervous system and they transmit the impulse to the cell body. They are usually, you can say, they are afferent in nature because they are carrying the impulses towards the cell body. So they are carrying the impulses towards the cell body of the neuron, and these dendrites are large in number, they also increase the surface area for the exception or receiving of the impulse. So these two functions of dendrite, that is increasing the surface area and carrying the impulses from the central nervous system to the cell body of the neuron. Then the axonal terminal, axonal hallux and the axon and the axonal terminal. The axon is the one large efferent process that carry the impulses away from the cell body. So this is the function of axon, that is carrying the impulse away from the cell body. And number two, it's the myelination. Here there is a presence of a myelin sheet over the axon, which is important for the saltatory conduction of a nerve impulse. That means that there is a faster rate of the nerve conduction due to the presence of a myelin sheet in the axon. This axon terminate is a axonal terminus. These terminals will have our vesicles, the synaptic vesicles, which are responsible for secreting the neurotransmitter at the synapse. I hope you will be explained well. Thank you for watching our video.